And welcome back to Let's Play Pillars of Eternity Blind. I'm the RPG chick, heading finally to the Elms Reach District to finally do our job, what we're supposed to be doing, to find Theas. There are many other quests which have to be done, but they will have to wait for now. Not guaranteed we won't put it off again at some point.
Eyes open.
I don't know why I'm sneaking, it just seems like a good idea. Elm's Reach. Ooh, the Temple of Helia. Again, it's like 1 hour between districts. It's crazy. Just to travel from the edge of one district to another. And where are we? We are here. Hi. Mind your path, Sestramor. The guided compass trusts easily, but I don't. I'm looking for the Temple of Helia. It lies beyond a north weald and up a mountain, but the faithful have fled, and now the priests of Casphath and Anwen linger on. Linger and hold old song. Blah. Okay, well, we're not going there yet. A menace roosts in Helia's temple and scattered her worshippers. I'm tasked with facing this threat. Alright, the dragon. Ooh, seek counsel from Helia herself in the Elms Reach district, which we just arrived in. Casphath and Anu and the two priests are in Old Song. Well, we've met them. They told us to go up there. Well, let's explore this side first. See what these people are saying instead of interrupting them. Size and youth made no difference for Oerenos. That's it? You have anything else to say? Peace upon your hearth. Truly, the heart burns brighter than any hearth. Okay, they're arguing now about that. Careful thought solves much indeed. Okay, I'm gonna leave that. Let's invade someone's home. Spread across a lumpy pallet of straw, the hide blankets are surprisingly soft. Rice, vegetables, and fruit. A wreath of straw woven with animal bones hangs from the shelf. We live in peace, but we'll never submit to Estramorin. Mind your manners, foreigner, and be welcome. Okay, so there's nothing much to do. There's no one to talk to in here. Oh, there's another box here. Ooh. I don't have that, do I? Ear of Glamfellen Part 2? I don't think I have any Ear of Glamfellen stuff. Now for a book.
I shall be quiet as a calm sea, which is not very quiet.
What? Fine.
Following your lead.
What?
Follow my lead over there.
If it makes you rest easier.
I can't get it. All right.
Eh?
Not without us, angering them. Maybe we'll find a copy somewhere else. I've never met an Estremor before, and neither has he. This Glanfathan stares at you and then slowly blinks away. A nimble tongue carries more sting than any blade. He blinks away as well. It's this way. Oh, back to old song. But wait, we came from old song and we were down here. Confident tribesmen. See what's going on over here. These people look confident. They're very confident. Dark Omen. Even the Delumgan could not stop him. Did I say it right? He's just a man. Powerful, but just a man. What's it talking about Theos, maybe? Worried Huntress. A Glanfathan woman stares at the ground. Her bushy eyebrows frown in a straight line. Never before has a man slipped past with so much ease. A sign. A dark sign. An elven man waves his hand in an arc over the ground. This is the confident tribesman. It has come to pass. At the end of the motion, his long fingers close into a fist. We could not have foreseen it. The Delumgan could not either.
Builder's wisdom to you.
All right. The Huntress shakes her head. And what does that tell us? She notices you, her thick eyebrows arching in surprise. Estremor, excuse us. We're not used to your kind here, under the great trees. If we can assist you, we will. Tell me about the man you speak of. Not Glanfathan. Broke into the tower. Here, in Elm's Reach. Nobody saw him come, not even the Delumgan. Tribesman says he moved in silence like a Stelgar in the shadows. Our hunters caught no scent until it was too late. The Huntress says, but we heard the stones crack. When he stepped inside Tir Evron, Dark Omen, I say this. Oh, that's where we're supposed to go speak to Helia. Delumgan, what are they? They are ancient children of the giant elms. Our people have lived with the two sisters in peace since we arrived hundreds of years ago. The Huntress says, Delumgan call us friends. We call them our own kin, our protection, their wisdom. Together we share a strong bond. Tribesman says, they have always lived under the shadow of the great elms. Walk until you cross the stream, and there you'll find the Delumgan sisters. Very well. So what's this? Another home. Okay. More fruits and veggies. Nobody here. Some mead. Ooh, camping supplies.
My eyes are...
Ooh, we discovered something. Let's look at this first.
My eyes are peeled.
Ooh, nice. Starlit garb. Exceptional. Spell defense bonus athletic. Plus 10 defense against spells. Plus 2 athletics. Light armor. This somber set of robes is flecked with bright, shimmering points of white, in imitation of a starry night sky. It was commissioned by an aging scholar whose love of astronomy and failing eyesight pressed her to request a set of enchanted garb which would allow her to pursue her studies for years to come. Need to clear some more crap. What is that doing there? So traps can only be three? Only stack by three? Why the hell is that the case? Fireball. Mm-hmm. Well, I saw this defense somewhere else. There we go. Minor endurance. Yeah, I might as well just sell that, actually. Alright. So who's wearing light? She is. I'm gonna keep my own thing. To do that. Okay, there it is. Okay, let's go. Okay, let's look at this home. It is a home, right? Glamfellen home, yeah. So there's the Twin Elms. There's Tyr Evron, there's the Blood Sands, and there's the Golden Grove. Ooh, cool. I want to see the Golden Grove. Potion of Iron Skin. Will they see me?
Be cautious. Be constant.
Where'd it go? I should have dragged it manually. Did it go into stash? It did. Let's drag this stuff in here until we know what to do with it. Deer wooden charm. Ooh, I want this stuff. Ooh, there's your Glamfath part one. The fire gives off the thick, rich odor of burning peat. Guard your tongue around three tusks, Stelgar. They are also quick to anger. What do you mean also? Peace be upon your hearth.
Eyes open.
Sorry, I hit that.
What?
I meant you. Damn it. I want that book. Man. Oh, in the Hall of Warriors. Okay. Let us stride forth into the Hall of Warriors. Nobody knows his power. Not the Delamgon, not us. We'll hunt him down, wherever he hides. Mind your manners, foreigner, and be welcome. You mind your manners. Seen that before. Alright, let's go into the Hall of Warriors. I like this. These huge, this huge fence. Anam Fatha oversee twin elms from the Passage of the Six. Yes, I am well aware of that. Many Estremoran come to study our mathematics. I don't know why they would do such a thing. What was... Oh, was something over here. Rite of Hidden Wonders. Can we hide? Can we hide?
Hello? Hello?
Shut up. Sneaking? Secrets? Plus 3 mechanics for 162 seconds. That could be handy for, And that's when I pierced a giant Stelgar with my spear, right through its heart. Oh, Arthan, I wish you could—I could have seen you do it. So that plus 3 mechanics scroll, me too, and maybe. That would be handy for undoing locks. Later, you can show us how you used your big spear. Huh. Oh well, yes, I can do that. Are they mocking him? I wish all hunters of twin elms were as young and strong as Arthan. As Arthan. Don't you have somewhere else to be? I'm listening to Arthan now. I guess they're serious about this Arthan guy. A lanky hunter grooms his stubble, a patched fuzz of blonde hairs, while listening attentively to a young elven woman. She whispers in his reddened ears and giggles. With his head still lowered, he flashes a wide smile in return. The hunter notices you. He clears his throat and straightens his back, adopting an air of dignity. I've been expecting you, champion of the Fangs. My tribesmen have told me that you're to speak the truth about Fjorm's exile. He combs his sparse stubble, darting a glance to the elven woman. Well, Arthan doesn't hide from the truth. Ask, and I'll answer. Oh, right. What's the guy's name? Redai or something like that? In the Passage of the Six? I think that's what he's talking about. What happened to Fjorm? He looks down and licks his lips. Fjorm? He pushes the blonde hair bristles away from the edges of his mouth. Every tribe knows his prowess, a hunter of great name, but this time he fell behind. We spotted the giant Stelgar on the Sentinel's Ridge, above the waterfall of the Northweald. It was stalking for prey. Arthan lightly shakes his head. Fjorm wanted us to split, He'd lure the beast to the river, and I'd flank it. The hunter scratches his flushed earlobe. But the beast didn't come down to the riverbank, so we tried to circle it on the ridge. I climbed faster, and there it was, ready to pounce on me. Arthur thrust his fist forward. I pierced flesh, midair, rolled over, and stabbed at it again, and again. And it was dead. The hunter pushes his mustache back and looks up. Fiorm couldn't believe he didn't earn the kill, not even a cut. He said he'd not return with the shame of losing to a twice-split arrow. I pleaded, but he was a keeper of the stone. He'd not listen, and now he's exiled. Who knows where? Tell me about your tribe. We're young, the youngest tribe near Glanfath. He hesitates for a moment, scratching his beard, and then spreads his long legs apart. But we're not weak. The other tribes have their history, and now we, the twice-split arrows, are making our own. He puffs his chest and pounds it with a fist. We're true Glanfathans, true hunters. I've proven our worth. The patches of golden stubble sparkle amidst a glowing smile. It was me, not Fiorm, who killed the giant Stelgar. Somehow I doubt that. Arthan claims that Fiorm exiled himself in shame after failing to kill a giant Stelgar in their blood hunt. Radai believes that Arthan, a member of the lower tribe, is lying for his own gain. I believe him, too. I spoke with Arthan in Elm's Reach. The hunter insisted that he was the one that killed the giant Stelgar in the North Weald near a ridge atop a waterfall. According to him, Fiorm couldn't bear the thought of losing to a hunter from a lower tribe. The twice split arrows and chose exile rather than return to Twin Elms in shame. Okay, I'm sure we'll find him out there in the North Weald. And then we'll see what's up. Did the builders make such grand things where you live? I don't even know, actually. Couldn't answer that.
My eyes are peeled.
Just looking around, little Stelgar. That's a nice doggy. Or is it a cat? I'm not even sure. Looks like a mangy mohawk cat or something. Okay, we go in there.
I shall be discreet.
Okay. Yeah, that's it. Okay. We'll go inside. Hello. Oh, I got pick locks with these guys here. Leaders like Simak have long protected us from the Estremoran. Simak has led the Three Tusks Stelgar as long as any of the Anamfatha. The hearth still smells of freshly cooked game. Grease spatters the blackened bricks. Bethel is too soft. It is good that Simak is here to provide another perspective. Ooh. School of Moonwell?
Shh.
Hmm? This won't work. Stelgar are watching us as well. The crates contain a few necessities of a Glamfellen traveling party. Furs and blankets, sturdy hide clothing, and gifts of carved Adra.
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
No, I don't need to be doing that right now. Let's go in here first.
What?
Light, flame, and sound. We'll keep to ourselves.
All right.
Sure.
Not taking anything from there. Come to treat with the three-tusked Stelgar? The Simak, yeah. Though simple and unadorned, the blades are made of sharp and finely tempered steel. Ooh, the Ethic Knoll. Oh, I want that. Adra Ban? White Adra is an extraordinarily rare precious stone found in some formations of Adra. It sometimes appears immediately adjacent to copper conductors used in Ingwithin structures. It has a luminous white color with pink and violet veins striations running through it.
Estremore?
A grizzled old elf, his hair braided and dyed, stands at one end of the hall. His arms and chest are cross-hatched with the pale seams of scars. His crooked smile looks like another. It's not many Estremoran who are permitted into our sacred city. Bethel must be feeling especially soft today. Adair pays no attention to the elf, and instead has locked eyes with the Stelgar in front of him. He whispers to you. Do you think he'd mind if I pet his Stelgar? Oh my god, Adair really has a thing for petting huge animals, doesn't he? Come to hear your future at Tir Evran? Simak's smile widens, exposing a row of yellow, crooked teeth. Or to make your own at Blood Sands. What's Blood Sands? An ancient place of sacrifice. He laces his fingers together. In a cave by the great elms themselves. Restin and his druids have been an integral part of Glamfellen society for generations. No matter what some of the other tribes might say, your Glamfellen has held its own against the Estremoran because some of us still understand the power of sacrifice. He gives you an appraising eye. Does the thought make you uncomfortable? It should. It's what kept our society alive for so long. He crosses his arms over his scarred chest. Something else? You don't seem fond of us, Estremoran. His hunched shoulders straighten. I fought in the Broken Stone War and the War of Black Trees. I saw my brethren cut down defending the places of the builders, and I shed blood alongside Gelvin Regid himself. Now the Estremoran seem to think that they will find a cure for their empty children among our sacred sites, or worse, that they will find sanctuary in our lands. His gaze darkens, and I've seen what happens when they set their sights on Glamfellen soil. Palagina says, they're desperate. The best of them want to find a cure. The worst are looking for an excuse to plunder. I don't know if I did a good idea with that. Good job with that. Isn't there room for you both? Huh. In 200 years, Defiance Bay and New Haymore have outgrown their own crooked cobblestones. They rupture and reek like bloated corpses. No, inviting them into our lands would be the end of us. In my 250 years, I've led my people through two wars. Our borders have remained intact, and largely through the reputation of Three Tusk Stelgar. His voice drops to a growl. I've sired a dozen children, but none have been deemed fit to take my place. I care nothing for the legacies that obsess the Estremoran lords, but it is important that my successor continue this path. Huh. Is your role hereditary? Not entirely. We believe that the souls of our ancestors come back to us, that a strong soul may bear many more, but all souls must be tested by our elders. The Rio looked first among my children for a successor, but their souls were weak. Ordinarily, they would turn to others in my tribe, to clan heads and their families. Ordinarily. He levels his gaze. But we share a tradition of fostering the children of other tribes, and the Anamphath of Fisher Crane has trusted his youngest to my care. He grimaces. And as none of my own blood are fit to take my place, the Rio will look next to this bog child, the kin of another Anamphath and my foster daughter, to take my place. Bogchild? His shoulders stiffen. I have nothing but respect for Fisher Crane, but their ways are not ours. The Orlans of Fisher Crane have lived in Thane Bog for a thousand years. They are cunning and furtive by nature, which serves them well when they have swamplands to hide their movements. He crosses his arms, but this will not deter the Estremoran on open ground. Palagina says, when the Republics were young, we sent explorers up through Thane Bog to find a faster way through to the Dwarven Kingdom of White March. Few returned. Samak points at the warriors gathered near the fire. Our savagery has deterred the Estremoran from further encroachment. They will tell of our deeds in the Broken Stone War. But if a child of Fisher Crane leads our tribe, we will lose that boldness, and the Estremoran will lose their fear of us. The child will be influenced by the souls of her ancestors. In times of crisis, she will look to her kin in Thane Bog for guidance. No matter what I might try to teach her, it will not be enough. He considers you. There is a way you could help. Few have the stomach for it, but I think it would suit someone of your inclinations. Go on. This Orlan girl has the soul of a leader. If it were passed to one of my own offspring, our tribe would remain strong. A Stelgar at Simak's side scratches its massive head on the Anamphath's leg. He remains steady on his feet. The druids of Blood Sands have a way to do this, and they understand the importance of a strong line of succession for Three Tusk Stelgar. Kana says, that didn't go where I expected it to. He's not one for half measures, is he? Samak gives you a key. There's a house in southeast Hearthsong next to the river. The child will be asleep, and I've arranged for her to be unattended for a time. His voice becomes a quiet rumble. Take her and bring her to Keeper Werda in Blood Sands. She knows what must be done. When she presents you with the liquid essence, bring it back to me. What are we going to do? Steal this kid's soul? What will Keeper Werda do with the child? His scarred face twists again. Have you seen the rituals of Blood Sands? She will sacrifice her. It's the only way to distill her essence. No, I have not. Palagina's lips curl into a sneer. How quick the old are to sacrifice the young for their purposes. The Orlan child? Go on. Tell me about the potion you need from Werda. Essence, bound and distilled into a liquid. It will have little immediate effect on me, but it will weave a stronger soul in my future issue. I don't think I'm going to do this, guys. Seriously. Remind me where I can find the child. She's staying in a house of in Hearthsong. Follow past the southeast side of the district until you reach the river. I don't see why you need me to do this. Because I cannot do it without attracting undue attention. He frowns. I don't relish passing my own burdens onto another, but this will incite war between our tribes if I am caught. How can you possibly expect to get away with this? few know the girl is here, and one Orland Babel looks much the same as the next. He shrugs. But let me worry about this. I should kill you for this? I won't do this. I do not relish the deed, but 2 centuries of leadership have taught me that all things bear a cost. He nods once. Consider it well, Estremor. I am not above rewarding those who are of service. Tell me about the 3 tusked Stelgar. The boldest and fiercest of the 6 great tribes of Irglanfath, it was we who first defended against the Estremoran who came to shore 200 years ago. He raises his chin. We have always been the border tribe, and it has always fallen to us to hold the line against outsiders and invaders. What do you do here? As Anamphath of 3 tusked Stelgar, I guide our tribe in all matters. He looks to the main room of the hut, where others have gathered. I am in Twin Elms to confer with some of the other Anamphatha about the Anulfin, your Hollowborn. We only have such births here on occasion, but it has made us more vigilant about our neighbors. One Stelgar stretches, flexing its claws. His eyes narrow. There are some of us who believe your Anulfin to be a punishment for the defilement of the Builder's sites. Others say it's a plague carried by the Estremoran. Canna says, a plague of the soul? An interesting concept, but it hasn't spread beyond the boundaries of the Deerwood. I don't want to get in a fight with them, but I want to tell them that I'm very, very, upset about this. You're killing an innocent baby. We would never do this. I should kill you for this. The Stelgar is at his side, growl. Surrounded by my best warriors? That would be unwise. That's all. I'm not doing that.
Eh?
I could just kill them, and that would wrap up the quest. Oh, who's this? Liras. A young man approaches you with a swift and purposeful stride. While you have never met him before, he has the same stern, wild look as Simak. He doesn't speak until he's right next to you. Oh, he's not there yet. When he does, his voice is quiet. Wait. I saw you speaking with my father. Say nothing. He glances back at the room with Simak. He's asked you to sacrifice Vela, hasn't he? He grits his teeth. Maybe he's right about 3 tusked Stelgar growing weak, but if this is the price of strength, it isn't worth it. The tribes have survived this long because we've stuck together. Hey, I'm on your side, guy. Ela says, a voice of reason. It's a wonder Simak didn't feed him to the Stelgars. I would never hurt the child. You did not seem like one who would. But my father will find someone who will. He doesn't give up on an idea easily. But there may be a way to stop him. I don't think sighing is it. He frowns. Or frowning. There's an herbalist among the Ovates of the Golden Grove. Bleda, that's her name. They all gather southeast of here by the river. She could brew a poison. Simak wouldn't know the difference until it's too late. You want me to murder your father? No, but it's better than allowing him to murder this child. Why not just return this child to her birth parents? It's complicated. A child sent to be fostered by another tribe isn't allowed to return. Unfortunately, explaining that we're shielding her from my father would make matters much worse for both tribes. He tugs at a thin braid. There's an easier way to kill Simak, you know. His warriors would surround you in no time. Besides, it's simplest if this happens quietly. Let me guess, if Simak dies, you're next in line. It's not like that. The Rio have already determined that my soul isn't strong enough. Whoever follows my father, it won't be me. Fine, I'll poison your father if you insist. With another glance at Simak's chamber, he backs toward the door. Like I said, you'll find Bleda in the Golden Grove. Good luck. Well, that's better. I wanted to hit that. Do what's right, Estremor. I'm counting on you. Simak's son Leras confronted me about his father's plan. He asked me to poison Simak instead. I can obtain a suitable poison from Bleda, one of the ovates of the Golden Grove. I just want to see if this guy has anything else to say. Now, oh, wrong tent or whatever. Well, I'm not going to warn him. Nope, nothing to say. Bye. You know, I'm going to call an episode here. I know they've been longer lately, but it's just how it's been working out. So thanks for watching. See you next time, and Endure. In Enduring, grow strong.